Chamon climbed over them. A curious sensation of excitement gripped him as thought he was about to make the most important discovery of his life. Something like a strain of music was troubling inside his head, telling him to go on, to hunt and search, to look for the princess. She could be any one of these, he told himself, as he stepped over a ring of sleeping schoolgirls in party dresses. But she's not, said he, the music in his head. He searched the east towards and the chapel. He found the king and queen. She, with her face all salty with dry tears, he in the act of blowing his nose. Then Charmon climbed the west tower and came to a bedchamber, especially full of flowers. The bed had white damask curtains, and the cover was embroidered with intertwining roses. And there on the pillow he saw a face which stabbed his heart like a needle. The most beautiful face he had ever seen. So deadly white was the princess that he took hold on the hand on the cover, thinking it would. Look at that drawing. Isn't it amazing? Lovely. Be cold. A drop of blood on the princess's fingers smeared his hand warm and wet. Then Prince Charming did something most improper for a prince of the royal blood. He should have waited. He should have asked permission of the king, of the queen, of the girl herself, but he could not help it. Her beauty had worked a kind of magic on his heart. He bent and kissed the sleeping princess on her lips. Something brushed his face. It was the princess's lashes. A flicker. Look, mother, I bruised my finger, she murmured, and sat up. Through the palace, dogs scratched, horses stomped, cats stretched, guards overbalanced, viscounts sneezed, the king blew his nose, the guests picked themselves up off the ballroom floor, and little girls asked if it was time to eat the birthday cake. Noise filled up each room and staircase and hall like a goblet filling with wine. But up in the white chamber in the west tower, neither Princess Charmant nor Princess Beauty spoke. They just looked at one another in wonder. She, 100 years older than he, yet not a day's difference in the age of their heart. Will you marry me? He said. I suppose I should now that you've kissed me, said Beauty. But first we'd better finish the game, hadn't we? Whose turn is it to count to 15 now? Wow. Thank you so much, my dear subscribers and new channel members. I'm so glad to see you here, and I would like to encourage you to support all the channels you visit, because people invest their time, and that is so nice when you appreciate their time by just liking their video or comment or donations. It's up to you guys. See you later and take care. Bye bye.